What's the dumbest mistake you've seen an incompetent coworker make? My wife worked at a gas station and found out her coworker, who had been there 4 years, had been refilling the napkin dispenser by cramming them one at a time through the front slot. She walked up and unfastened the back and apparently his jaw hit the floor. He had never considered that there might be a better way to do this. Working in pharmacy, a pharmacist gave a customer a flu shot and threw the used syringe in the container with the new syringes instead of the container to dispose them. Another pharmacist went to grab a new syringe later on and ended up getting stabbed with the used syringe. Caused a total storm. I worked as a radiation protection tech at a power plant that was refueling. My job was to sit outside of a contaminated area, and if anyone wanted to take something out of the area, tools, etc., I had to make sure it didn't have any radioactive particles on it. To do this, you wipe the tool with something like a tissue, and then hold the tissue up to a machine called a frisker. If the needle on the frisker goes above a threshold, then the tool has to be cleaned or left in the area. One day I come back to relieve a guy who had been sitting outside the area for 2 hours. He tells me there's been no issues and everything has cleared. I look at the frisker, lean over and turn the machine on. Removing the plastic wrapping from a pallet of 5-gallon cans of highly flammable acetone. He didn't have a box cutter, so he proceeded to melt it with a lighter. Shut down a critical file server, then lied about it. Point. Even after he was presented with the logs that showed it was his user account that initiated the shutdown. It's not so much the mistake that he made, but it was when he lied about making the mistake. Point. That was a rookie move. My coworker at the bowling alley had to walk down a lane where a group of very young children, maybe 4 to 8 years old, were bowling to retrieve a ball that had stopped in the gutter about halfway down to the pins. When he had picked up the ball, my other coworker told him to go walk it back down to the children. However, this guy had it in his mind that it would be best to bowl it back down at the group of small children instead. Luckily, one of the adults with the children was a big muscular guy who was able to stop the ball and pick it up without anybody getting hurt. Poured sink cleaning solution into the ice cream machine instead of the cream mixture, and I had to stop them. They then said, "I'm sure it'll be fine. It was only a little. No, that would poison people." I had to clean out the whole machine top to bottom and refill it. I ended up throwing away nearly a whole bucket full of contaminated ice cream mixture. I would also like to add that the containers didn't look anything alike. The sink stuff came in big plastic jugs with screw tops, and the ice cream comes in cardboard cartons, like orange juice, that you have to cut open. So I don't know how she could have possibly mixed the two up. Was making pizza. Guy broke the pizza board, the thing with the handle you make the pizza on, and then slide the pizza into the oven. I found the other one, and he lost that. So I told him to make pizzas on one of the plastic cutting boards. He put the pizza into the oven on the board, and just left it. The board melted. No more pizza that day. I used to work for a landscaping company, and over the course of a summer I witnessed one of my co-workers accidentally set 3 different things on fire. A hedge trimmer, a truck, and himself. The office we worked in was shut down due to COVID and the company went 100% remote. A new senior engineer was hired to work directly with our product team, and also manage a team of developers, during our company-wide weekly Zoom meeting. After he was done presenting for the company, he turned his camera off, but forgot to put himself on mute. 100 plus people heard this man playing Fortnite and talking down about the company to someone else in the background, among other things. He only lasted a month. When I was in the Navy, this known dumbass and pathological liar was on armed watch with an M14 patrolling the topside decks. Literally all you have to do is walk around for 4 hours with a rifle on your shoulder. This dude came back to the quarterdeck, main entrance to the ship, with no gun. He tried to claim it fell off his shoulder and into the water while tying his shoe. How a rifle would fall off your shoulder, pass through your hands that were tying the shoe, and through all 3 lifelines, like guardrails, is still a mystery. My theory is that he was doing drill team stuff, like tossing it spinning in the air, and lost it that way. I used to work as a pharmacy tech. Most antibiotics for kids come as powder in a bottle. We add distilled water to make it liquid upon receiving prescriptions, as the solution only remains stable for 10 to 14 days. depending. One day, a father drops an amoxicillin prescription for a child. Usual questions are asked: age, weight, allergies, type of infection, desired flavor. Product is prepared and given to the father. He leaves. 2 hours later he comes back, says the medication smells funny. I think duh, medication often do, but I still waft the scent with my hand to my nose and point, he's right, something is off. I give the bottle to the pharmacist. He agrees and makes another bottle right away. The original Antibio bottle smelled like straight up alcohol. In a lab, we keep multiple solvents for many years: water, simple syrup, mineral oil, ethanol. One of the techs added ethanol to the antibiotic instead of water, and we were all flabbergasted as how the mistake could have occurred, because all the solvents are 1. Of different size, 2. Of different label color, and 3. Identified in huge letters. We identified the tech guilty of that mistake and they couldn't even say how that error occurred. New temp to hire admin. She was supposed to order lunch for a big meeting. They told her where to order from, and how many omnivores, vegetarians, and vegans. She showed me the order she was going to place, and I corrected her, pointing out she didn't have any vegan food or enough vegetarian. She told me I was wrong and ordered anyway, even with me screeching at her not to do it, and explaining what was wrong. Omnivores got beef, vegetarians got chicken, it's not meat. Vegans got salads with egg and cheese, but it has vegetables. She was not hired on full time. I worked for a non-profit that hired a guy in fundraising purely for his Rolodex, and they couldn't care less about any of his job functions, as long as he kept bringing more rich people to fundraiser parties. Well, when the pandemic hit and we were forced to go remote, it became clear how incompetent he was with technology, and how he'd been coasting for years in the office by sticking to phone calls instead of email, etc. We had our first major online fundraiser coming up, and I warned my boss that this dude had no idea how Zoom worked, never muted himself, camera up the nose, treated it like watching a YouTube video. But again, he was the guy inviting all the rich people to the event, so they didn't want to lecture him about a computer program and hurt his ego. Then in our massive 200 plus person Zoom event, he set his laptop on the bathroom counter and proceeded to take a shirtless, nasty old man dump, complete with grunting, splashing, and squelching. It was so loud it drowned out the speaker. They had to end the event early because they had no way to mute him, and it kept going for a full 2 minutes with no sign of stopping. I nearly threw my laptop out a window that night. One volunteer had no computer experience. We showed her step by step how to do her job. She didn't know what a mouse was, how to click on something, etc. We got her up and running. She was pleased with herself at having gotten the hang of using a PC. Fast forward 2 hours. Come back to the office and she's in tears. I swear I didn't do anything. There were just fish everywhere all of a sudden. Look at the computer. Aquarium screensaver. After her little breakdown, she had to take the rest of the afternoon off. I worked in a veterinary hospital for a good number of years. One day, unknown to me, some little girl had found a dead/dying seagull with her family and brought it in to see if we could help it, but it has passed by the time they arrived. Our veterinary technician took said bird for disposal, but was too busy to deal with it then, like put it in the freezer, 1 minute tops with labeling. So instead he just packed a box with the dead bird into our storage area with dozens of similar boxes and just leaves it there. Days go by while he is still working, I should add, and I come back on shift and something is seriously rank in the office. Customers are complaining. No one knows what would cause it, but I eventually find the box buried beneath other supplies. I walk up to my head receptionist and say, "So, seagull," and watch the absolute fury grow in her eyes. The tech did not last long after that. A guy was using the overhead crane in a machine shop I worked in. It had two hooks on it. One was raised right to the roof, the other was lowered and beside another guy's machine. The guy using the crane was looking at the hook by the roof and mobilized the crane. He was wearing earmuffs and the shop is loud af, so when he started almost killing everyone in the line of machines with the other hook, he couldn't hear the rest of us screaming. The hook almost threw the first guy into his lathe, hit the next guy's tool board, flipped over to the side he was on, almost put him into his lathe, rinse and repeat for the next three machines. When it bounced over the last one, it grabbed the A-frame, that held all the bar stock and started lifting 30-40 t of steel off the ground. Someone finally made it to him and slapped the controls out of his hands. That was his last day at that job. Nearly leaving a child behind on a field trip, we took a large group of 4- and 5-year-old children to visit a farm/petting zoo/pumpkin patch. We had 3 vehicles. I was in charge of my own group, but I noticed one of the other teachers was being very lax in her supervision for most of the trip. When it was time to leave, I loaded my children on the bus with some other adults and did a head count/attendance check. Before getting on my bus, I noticed that the other teacher had climbed onto her bus and sat down before the children boarded. She walked on first and had the kids follow her. I almost let it go, but gut instinct told me she wasn't counting her students. Once they were all boarded, I walked back and climbed on her bus. She seemed irritated when she realized I was checking on her. I was not a supervisor or anything, just a fellow teacher. So she didn't answer to me in any way. She said something like, "We're all good, let's go." I knew how many were in each group, so without answering her, I did a quick count. Sure enough, we were missing one. I ended up leaving the bus and going to find the kid myself. He was still on the playground with children from another school. When we got back to the bus, the other teacher blamed the kid. She said he wandered off. Really? She is the one who gathered the group and left the play area, meaning she is the one who wandered off. She was pissed when I went to the administration about the incident.